This is Dr. T.V. Rao, Professor and Principal, DBS Institute of Technology, Kavali. So today, I am going to explain extended surfaces. So it is also called as fins. So we are going to discuss heat transfer in extended surfaces. Okay. So generally, so heat transfer we can increase by increasing the surface area. With this concept, they develop so extended surfaces or fins to increase the heat transfer. So in the extended surface also, here we are increasing the surface area. With the help of extended surfaces, we can increase the surface area. By increasing surface area, we can increase heat transfer. So this extended surfaces had various practical applications nowadays we are using. So in mechanical engineering, in electronics engineering, in computer science, in chemical industries, okay, in like this, irrespective of the field of application, the field of engineering, we are using in many areas these applications, the extended surfaces or fins applications we are using. Even so, in electronic components also, so there will be this, we are using this concept for cooling of these electronic components. So this extended surfaces, generally we call it as fins. So fins are generally used to enhance the heat transfer from the given surface. So the fins we are using to increase heat transfer. So heat transfer rate ni increase cheyadam kosam manam fins use chestunnam. Enduku use chestunnam? To increase the heat transfer. So in addition of fins, we can increase the heat transfer from the surface by several folds. That means fins arrangements is something like a folds. There will be several folds. With the help of the several folds, we can increase the surface area. Once increase the surface area, automatically we can increase the heat transfer. There are some applications of this fins. Typical applications like radiators for automobiles, air cooling of cylinder heads of internal combustion engines. We can internal combustion engines. So top of the engines, we can find the arrangement of so many fins, like scooters, motorcycles, and aircraft engines and air compressors. Like this, every engine, most of the engines, most of the machineries had the applications of the fins. So this extended surfaces, so here the energy transfer by conduction within the boundaries. Up to boundaries there is energy transfer by conduction. After that, how there is a heat transfer, either by convection and radiation between the boundary and at surroundings. Okay, so here there is a small example shown. There is a stud. So this stud we joining two metal plates. Okay, so here the temperature T1 and here is the temperature T2, and from this, so inside the stud the heat is transferred by conduction. After that, to the surroundings heat is transferred by convection and radiation. So temperature is slowly reducing when there is a conduction, convection and radiation. When length increases, slowly the temperature decreases from T1 to T2. So heat transfer from extended surfaces. The most frequent application of the extended surface is used specifically to enhance the heat transfer rate between solid and adjoining fluid. Suppose this is a fin. Up to the surface, there is a heat is transferred by conduction. After the from surface to surrounding, the heat is transferred by convection. Okay, so from the surface to the surroundings, heat is transferred by convection. So what is that particular amount of heat transfer? H A into T S minus T infinity, where H is a convect heat transfer coefficient, area is surface area, and T S means surface temperature, and T infinity means surrounding temperature. At the same time, so over the surface, sometimes the fluid is stagnant, and sometimes there is a flow of fluid or air. So when the velocity increases, also the heat transfer rate also increases. That also we'll see. For fixed temperature, the surface temperature, two ways to enhance the heat transfer. Either one is increase the fluid velocity. So how to increase the fluid velocity? You have to keep a blower or air pump. If you keep a blower or heat pump, means the fluid, it flows at very high velocity. So once there is a high velocity, there will be more amount of heat transfer. Or T infinity could be reduced. That means our atmospheric temperature should be reduced. By these two ways, we can increase the heat transfer. Okay. So there will be some limitations. Many situations would be encountered in which increasing the H to the maximum possible value is either insufficient to obtain the desired heat transfer and associated cost. So here, and one more thing also is there. Either if you use a fluid with a high convective heat transfer coefficient, also we can increase heat transfer. This is also another way. So this is the arrangement of a. This will be the arrangement of a fin. So there is a vertical surface. Over that there will be some horizontal surfaces attached. So like this, here he has shown only two. Like this, there will be many fins will be there. So if like that, if you add many fins, means the surface area we can increase. How about increasing surface area? By increasing the surface area by adding fins. And one more thing, to increase this heat transfer rate based on the material. So material had a K value. K means thermal conductivity. If you increase the thermal conductivity also, we can increase the more amount of heat. That is one way. So like this, one way we can increase the thermal conductivity, you can increase the heat transfer. The fin material should have large K value to minimize the temperature variance from its base to the tip. So infinity thermal conductivity, that means the infinity thermal conductivity means K should be very, very large. Like this, we can increase the more amount of heat transfer. So again, we'll see some more applications. The arrangement of cooling engine heads on motorcycles and lawn motors. So this is a IC engines. There will be engine head. Engine head is completely covered with. So there will be so many fins. So here, with the help of these fins, there will be air cooling takes place. Like this, the heat is transferred from the engine to the surroundings, and it can maintain a constant head temperatures, such that the engine, without knocking, engine can work. At the same time, air conditioners also, we find there will be so many fins or arrangements. With this, there will be heat transfer takes place. And in case of electrical transformers, So electrical transformers, when there is a conversion of high voltage to the low voltage, lot of heat will be produced. So the additional heat produced by the transformer will be carried out with the help of the fins. There is an electronic circuits. In electronic sets, circuits also, there is a over this main processor, top of the processor, there will be a fins arrangement. With the help of the fins arrangement, the cool, the temperature can be maintained. So these are the some of the applications of fins. So there will be the fins had, there will be various classifications. This is another, so another special types of fins. So the fins are the various types of fins we can use, like longitudinal fins, concentric fins, pin fins, plate fins, like this. So this is a longitudinal fin, and based on this cross section, this is a triangular fin. So this is a annular fin. Throughout the diameter circumference, there will be a fin. This is a pin fin. Like this, there are various types of fins we are using for different applications. But whatever the fin it may be, the direction of heat transfer from the boundaries is perpendicular to the principal direction of heat. So here, what is the direction of heat transfer that is perpendicular to this? Perpendicular heat transfer from the boundary is perpendicular to the principal direction of heat transfer to the solid. Perpendicular to the direction, principal direction of heat transfer in the solid. So in the solid, whatever the direction of there is a heat transfer, so here the direction of heat transfer from the boundary is perpendicular to the direction of heat transfer. That is from this surface. So there will be a perpendicular direction, there will be heat transfer. So for this heat transfer, so first of all, we should find out the differential equation. We should find out the differential equation, how there is a heat transfer, how much heat is transferred with the help of the fin. So here, general conduction analysis, here he has taken a pin fin, and he has taken a small element. He has taken a small element at a distance of x. So there is a heat transfer of Qx, and dx, at the distance of x plus dx, there is heat transfer of Qx plus dx. So during this element, there will be heat transfer of d convective. This is a convective heat transfer. Okay. So the convective heat transfer is in the perpendicular to the direction of surface. So here there is a heat transfer. So convective heat transfer takes place in perpendicular direction. And this DAS is the surface area. Okay, so DS is the thickness of the element. And to find out the differential equation, we should make some assumptions to simplify the problem. So with the help of some assumptions, so this is very, very complicated problem. So with the help of these assumptions, we make a very simplified. So what is that assumption? So here we take one-dimensional heat transfer. So we take one-dimensional heat transfer, and we assume that it is a steady state and K is constant, no heat generation, negligible radiation. So we are assuming that there is no radiation heat transfer. In Y and Z direction, there is no heat transfer. H is uniform over the surface. Throughout the surface, H is constant. With these assumptions, now we are going to find out the differential equation. So we have taken a small element, So here there is a qx, here there is a qx plus dx. At a distance of x, the heat transfer is qx. At a distance of x plus dx, qx plus dx. And this is a convective heat transfer coefficient. If you take energy balance over this element, qx equal to input energy equal to qx, output energy equal to x, qx plus dx plus q convective. What is qx? That is minus ka into dt by dx, where AC is the cross sectional area. And what is qx plus dx? Qx plus dx, we can write it as qx plus d by dx of qx into dx. And q convective, you can write it as ha. Here, a is dA into t minus t infinity. This, if you simplify and if you substitute in this equation, if you substitute in the energy balance equation, we will get this the differential equation for pinfin. Similarly, but our main focus is first we have to calculate the heat transfer equation for a rectangular fin. This is a rectangular fin. So this is a surface, this is a fin, it is a rectangular of length L, width W and thickness T. And this is, here also if you take a small rectangular element, okay, so here surface temperature is, we assume that it is a TB, where x equal to 0, the surface temperature is TB, and here AC is constant, this is a cross sectional area. So cross sectional area over the entire fin, it is a constant, and the surface area AX equal to P into P means perimeter into X. The surface area of the, if you take a pin, perimeter into the length X length, where X is measured from the base. P is a fin perimeter. So D by DX of AX equal to P. A means P into X. Okay. So already we have derived the differential equation, and the differential equation, if you substitute these things, we'll get a simplified form as d square t by dx square minus hp by ka into t minus t infinity equal to 0. So this is a differential equation for rectangular fin. What is the differential equation? D square t by dx square minus hp by ka into d minus t, t minus t infinity equal to 0. Still again with this we will simplify. How we will simplify means, so let us we take theta equal to t minus t infinity. Theta equal to t minus t infinity. What is, if theta equal to t minus t infinity, what is d theta by dx? So it is nothing but dt by dx. Because t infinity is a constant, it becomes 0. So d theta by dx equal to dt by dx. This if you simplify, this if you substitute in this previous equation, instead of dt by dx, if you substitute d theta by dx, it becomes dou square t by dou x square minus m square theta equal to 0. So what is m square? M square also we are assuming that hp by kac, hp by ka we will assume it as m square. Hp by ka we will assume it as m square. So dou square theta by dou x square, d square theta by dx square minus m square theta equal to 0. So this is a second order differential equation. It is a second order homogeneous differential equation. So for such kind of the differential equation, the solution is, so theta equal to c1 into e to the power of mx plus c2 into e to the power of minus mx. For second order differential equation, the solution is theta equal to c1 into e to the power of mx and c2 plus c2 into e to the power of minus mx, where c1 and c2 are constants. So to find out the c1 and c2, you have to apply the boundary conditions. So boundary conditions for different types of fins, the boundary conditions may change. Okay, so how to find out this c1 and c2, what are those boundary conditions, that we'll discuss in the next class. But for fin, the differential equation is dou square theta by dou x square minus m square theta equal to 0. And the solution is theta equal to c1 into e to the power of mx plus c2 into e to the power of minus mx. So we have to find out what is on C1 and C2. And to find out C1 and C2, we have to apply boundary conditions. Boundary conditions are different for different situations, different types of fins. Those types of fins we will discuss next class. Okay. So today we have discussed what is meant by extended surfaces. So why we have to use extended surfaces? What are the different applications of the extended surfaces? What are the different types of fins? How to find out the differential equation for the fin? So for rectangular fin, what is the differential equation? What is the solution for the differential equation? These things today we have discussed. Okay. So with this, today I'll stop. Thank you.